Hey Wild Ones, I'm Lucy, and this is Pussy Powered. Today's video is about sexual debriefing. While it may not sound super fun and sexy, it's something that goes a really long way in creating an amazing sex life. In a nutshell, sexual debriefing is taking some time after sex, not immediately after, but maybe even the next day, to share what you liked, what worked for you, what didn't work for you, and what you would love to try in the future. This is an important and often overlooked part of communication, something that can help avoid a lot of assumptions and not so fun experiences in the bedroom. Now, the reason you don't want to do this immediately after sex, like literally when you're done, is because you're still going to be in an altered state, and that is often not the best time to communicate things that may be a little bit touchy. So first things first, set some time aside, ideally again the next day. That's when we really love to break things down. And for us, especially when we try a new kind of scene or we play around with a different kink or something that we don't usually do, we give ourselves ample time for aftercare and to just simmer in the yumminess and the emotions, the feelings of the experience before we start talking about the logistics of what we liked and didn't like. Some of our favorite ways to debrief about a sexual experience are going out for a walk, going out for a drive, over coffee, over dinner, whatever works for you and your lover to carve out some time to connect with as few distractions as possible, even if it's just for 5 to 10 minutes. I highly encourage you to spend at least a little bit of time debriefing after every experience, as often as possible. Also, please note that this is separate from aftercare. While I did mention in a previous video that one expression of aftercare may be to have a sexy recap, that's more of a playful, like, hey, I really loved it when you nibbled on my neck, and not a very thorough debrief. So I hope that that clears up any potential misunderstanding about intermingling aftercare with a debrief. As much as possible, keep these two separate. Now, when you're ready for your debrief, here are a few guiding questions you may want to use. One, I really enjoyed it when, fill in the blank. I really enjoyed it when you grabbed my neck. I really enjoyed it when you pulled my hair, when you nibbled on my thighs. Whatever you enjoyed, be sure to emphasize that first and take turns sharing about what you really enjoyed. Number two, something I'd love more of is, we're not saying, ah, I really didn't like it when you did this. Can you just do that instead? Notice we're not leading with what we do not like. We're keeping the focus on what we would like more of. For example, if he goes straight for the clit every time he goes down on you and you don't want that exactly, you can say, hey, I'd really love more nibbling around my thighs and more teasing around my vulva before you start sucking on my clit. Do you see the distinction? One may land in a more critical way where they may get the sense that, oh, I'm doing this wrong. Whereas leading with, hey, I would really love if you did more of this, it helps to focus on that and the excitement and the anticipation of experiencing more of that. Third, one of my favorite moments was when you grabbed me by the ankles and pulled me close to you. Be as descriptive and enthusiastic as you can genuinely be. The way that we share about these experiences really makes an imprint on our lovers, and it helps to either encourage or discourage certain things from happening in the future. So ideally, you want to focus on encouraging again what you want more of instead of simply discouraging what you don't want. Just basic law of attraction principles here. Fourth, next time, how about we fill in the blank? Next time, how about we start with some naked dancing before we get on the bed? Next time, how about we spend some more time looking into each other's eyes? Next time, how about we remove each other's clothes? Keep it as playful and, again, enthusiastic as possible. The energy that you get in response to that kind of energy is completely different than whatever critical energy you may have possibly expressed in the past. And even when something does come up that you absolutely do not want to do again, communicate it in a loving and curious way. Not only saying, hey, I never want to do this again, but also introducing an alternative or multiple alternatives that you would be willing to try instead. And by the way, if you're excited to amp up your play and try new things in the bedroom, spice up your sex life, and deepen your connection with your lover, check out my new program, The 25 Days of Play, at the link in the description below. And as a valued subscriber, use code GETWILD for 10% off. All right, Wild Ones, that's it for today. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more on sexual empowerment and healing for women and people with vulvas. In the meantime, here's to your awakening well-being and your pleasure for a pussy-powered life.